Austin, getting ready for SummerSlam, is Mr. Perfect in singles competition here this week. Also in singles competition, we'll see Tito Santana in tag team action, the fabulous Rougeau Brothers, and comments from Hulk Hogan and Brutus the Barber Beefcake. But right now, let's go up to ringside. Well, you can hear the fans.
Tony, unfortunately, the finals will not be on the line in tag team championship. Not up for grabs, but what an opportunity for the Hart Foundation. You know, Tony, a lot of people ask me why in a last minute like this, maybe 48 hours away from the big event, the guys like the Hitman and the Anvil take a match. It's important to keep sharp, to keep close, and to know what the other guy's thinking all the time.
You know, we say it could be a great match, and it probably will be a great match against the Brainbusters, and that is unless Bobby the Brain Heenan and Andre the Giant and maybe a chair would get involved once again.
Well, Bobby the Brain Heenan is making a habit out of collecting titles for the Heenan family or stable, however you want to put it. He won't have anything to lose in the Meadowlands, though, except perhaps the Intercontinental title.
That's right, against the Ultimate Warrior. Look at that. The Hitman not taking any guff at all from Tom Stone, who pulled his hair. And now Joey Morella warns both men.
Very hard to repeat, Tony, in here in the World Wrestling Federation. A once-year champion, especially tag team champions, to have the title, lose it, and get it back, very difficult.
Leapfrog that time. The Hitman.
Right down. It looks like he injured that right knee. That could be a big, big problem.
Look at the angle, though. Boy, he took care of Tom Stone.
He was playing possum.
That's right. The Hitman came right up that time. Hear some pre-recorded comments from the Hart Foundation.
Hey, Bobby Heenan, the Brainbusters. Come this Monday night at the SummerSlam, you want to make some noise with the big boys.
Yeah, there's going to be some noises, man. There's going to be slaps. There's going to be punches. There's going to be joggers. No, no, no. I'm not going to attack yourself. I'm not going to attack anybody.
You think the Anvil's ready?
Oh, my goodness.
You betcha he's ready. All eyes will be on the Meadowlands this Monday night. Look at this, slam after slam. What a powerhouse.
The Anvil, like you said, Gorilla, is prepared. And I can only think that there are plans, as far as Bobby the Brain Heenan and the Brainbusters are concerned, to do some damage to the Hart Foundation, because it's a non-title match, and you got to realize these guys are top contenders.
Well, once again, the Brainbusters are going to be in the same situation they were in when they met Demolition. If they go out there and try to match power blow for blow with these guys, forget about it. They're going to come up with a short end of the stick. They got to rely on cunningness. They got to rely on their speed, their agility, and their wrestling knowledge.
Oh, holding the head. Oh, he's biting Milliman right on the head. You can better believe the Hart Foundation will be first in line to try to get a title shot from the Brainbusters. Oh, big slug. And some great matchups, Gorilla, when you think about the Anvil going up against a powerhouse like Arn Anderson.
That's going to be something else. Arn Anderson can match power with most guys, but I think the Anvil's going to have the edge in that respect as well. And, you know, should they be successful this coming Monday night, they will undoubtedly be the number one challengers and will get a title shot within the next 30 days. Look out! Bombs away, forget about it. It's history right now.
Jake Milliman is history, and it's all Hart Foundation. Let's get the official word.
Here are your winners, the Hart Foundation.
Foundation looking good. Let's go back and take a look at what went down earlier on. Slam after slam by the powerhouse, the Anvil. This guy doesn't have a clue how strong he really is.
You're right.
There's no leverage involved there. That's just brute force, and then look at that move. Brainbusters, look out.
Look out. Right now, let's go to our special report.
From the World Wrestling Federation magazine, this is Special Report.
Hello, everyone. I'm Lord Alfred Hayes with this week's special report. Recently on Primetime Wrestling, the co-host Roddy Piper was involved in a fiery dispute with Ravishing Rick Rude and his manager Bobby the Brain Heenan. Here is what took place.
I said I've had three successes. What is your major malfunction?
If you try wearing the pants in the family, brother, you might get along with
where
one man.
I come from, we don't consider that kind of stuff humorous. We have a
where
nice...
Where you come from is easier, subterranean Rod. Country, my man.
Oh, and exactly where is it that you come from, you...
I come from the top of the mountain, and you're going to find that out, Piper.
You think because you're some kind of champion all of a sudden, you think you're the only one that's ever been a champion? Is that your problem,
no,
huh?
No, I'm not the only one that's ever been a champion, but I'm the best champion there's ever been. Whoa. And you can't do a thing about it because you ain't physical enough for me, my man.
I'm not physical enough.
That's right. Nobody wears a skirt and dominates Ravishing Rick
That's
Rude.
That's about all. Let me tell you something right now. Let's just stop this right now because I don't want to go any further. I don't want to change with you no more. I don't want no trouble. You just leave me alone and you go away and save your own life.
Leave you alone?
Yes.
Leave you alone. No, you're so easy to pick on, Piper. You're right there.
Shut
man.
Your mouth, I said to you. I'll tell you what to do. No. I can settle this. You stay in Studio B. You don't move an inch. Don't let your... Don't do nothing. Don't brush your hair. Don't touch your mustache. You just stay there. Be a good boy. Stay with Boosie.
Wait a minute, Piper. You coming for me? You don't have to look too far. I'll find
Rick,
you. Hold it, Bobby.
No, Rick.
Kenan, I'm holding you directly responsible here.
You're holding me responsible.
You created this whole situation.
You start UA Demon. He's got a match with the Ultimate Warrior. Come on. I can't have him out in the hallway getting in a fight or something.
Nobody
I want somebody
asked
from this...
you to bring a guest here,
No. I want somebody from this complex right now to put a stop to it. Somebody get somebody out there right now.
Okay, what exactly is the problem here?
No problem
How
here.
Are we, huh?
No problem here.
Well, where's the champion?
No problem here.
Where is it? No problem here. What is your mouth?
What's wrong with you?
What's wrong with
you? Where's Big Bad Piper now? What are you doing over there, Piper? I told you I was coming to get you, and lo and behold, you disappeared. What about a macho? Big bad Roddy Piper. And ran. And all I seen was his skirt tails. I didn't even see his skirt tails.
That's the last time you're gonna say that!
Come on,
what you do? Do me a favor for one thing. Don't do me a favor. Just stay. Please,
I'm moving a muscle.
I'm down on my knees.
Come on, Piper, quit your talk.
I'm begging you.
Piper.
You just stay
you
there.
You don't have to beg me.
One more sound, I'm going to drown you.
Come on,
you just
Piper.
Stay right where you are.
Come on,
don't
little
you
man.
Move an inch. You just stay there.
Come and
talk.
Get it.
I won't bother you. You won't have nothing to do with
you
me.
You ain't nothing.
Why are you creating all
I'm
these
gonna
problems?
I'm going to need some help.
So
get some help now. That man runs his mouth, and
who
he's got nothing.
Come over here.
He's got nothing.
Come over here.
I'm the Intercontinental Champion. I deserve respect from you. And I deserve respect from Rowdy.
What exactly is your problem, huh?
Oh,
you
right.
Have a problem
come
with
on,
you.
Son.
You have a piece of me.
I have
you
a piece of me.
All you are me.
You are a jerk.
All you are.
Relax.
You're
not
going to
accept
relax.
Relax.
Having seen this explosive confrontation with Rowdy Roddy Piper, one wonders why Rick Rude would do this when he will surely have his hands full this Monday night at SummerSlam, where he defends his title against the Ultimate Warrior. For the World Wrestling Federation, this has been a special report.
Tony, I don't believe it. Big title defense coming up this coming Monday night for Ravishing Rick, and here he's making waves with the hot rod, the most dangerous man in professional wrestling.
You gotta believe that Ravishing Rick Rude has plenty on his mind with the Ultimate Warrior, and now he has even more on his mind with Randy Walls.
Randy, I think that's a big mistake.
Perfect with a big confrontation against the Red Rooster during SummerSlam as he takes Dale Wolf down to the mat.
Oh, look at that cross face. Nice amateur movement there.
Well, I know he is sending a signal, if anything else, to the Red Rooster that this man, Mr. Perfect, has plenty of ability as he slugs away. We have some pre-recorded comments from one Mr. Perfect. Let's go to those right now.
This Monday night, Red Rooster, SummerSlam. I suggest you watch every move I make and prepare yourself as good as you possibly can. I'll leave you with this message, Red Rooster. Nobody beats Mr. Perfect. Nobody.
Well, that remains to be seen, and it won't take too long to find out either. About 48 hours away here. All eyes will be on the Meadowlands, East Rutherford, New Jersey. It is heating up, Tony. I can feel it.
Well, you can see it on the face of Mr. Perfect. And as you know, Gorilla, preparation in a big event such as SummerSlam is so important. But you got to believe that if there's anybody prepared, it's got to be this man, Mr. Perfect.
Well, careers will be broken and careers will be made in SummerSlam. You can depend on that. The ramifications of winning or losing in the Meadowlands on Monday night could be tremendous.
And don't forget, the entire world will be with us, and you can be with us also at home on pay-per-view. So make sure you call your local cable systems to inquire about pay-per-view availability. And see us at SummerSlam.
You folks out there that are still thinking about it, what are you waiting for? Get up, go to the phone now, and call them up. You're going to be shut out.
So Danny Davis trying to move Mr. Perfect away from the corner, and he is all over Dale Wolf, there is no doubt. And now, look at this move. Well, you can see that one coming.
Then they're going to blame me, Tony, the guys that don't make it. The guys and gals that get shot out are going to blame me. I'm telling you now, go and call right now. I don't want to take that responsibility.
I wouldn't want to either, bro.
Sends him in, look at this. Oh, nice move by the youngster.
Right to the nose, and Dale Wolf gets a response from the fans as he goes after Mr. Perfect, but he wanted Mr. Perfect to get up, but that may have been a mistake.
Once a guy is down, keep him down if you can. Well, that was a perfect slam. The dropkick left a little bit to be desired, but the slam was nice.
Well, it was right on the hand that time, but it didn't get much height out of it. And Wolf sent him in. Oh, Mr. Perfect, too much for him there. Wolf is down. And look at that move by Mr. Perfect.
Now, there's a dropkick right there. One in the ribs and right under the chin with the other one. Look, where's he going now? Yeah. High risk move here.
What's he going to do? How many times have we seen this from Mr. Perfect? Not many times. As he goes up, look at that.
Now you're going to see.
Well, I was afraid of that.
I think we were all waiting for that, and you got to believe that the Red Rooster's watching this. If there's anyone prepared, anyone ready for SummerSlam, it is Mr. Perfect. Look at that.
It's all over but the shouting. Once you lock the fingers, it's over.
Your winner is Mr. Perfect.
Feel the heat. See SummerSlam this Monday night. Available on a pay-per-view basis. Call your local cable company for availability.
SummerSlam.
Martel and Santana, former tag team champions, now enemies.
Right you are. Now going up against Jim Gorman in this event, Tito Santana.
I don't like Gorman's chances, Tony.
I don't either, especially that SummerSlam is this Monday, and you know that Tito Santana is the type of man to be ready for a big event. Now, he's not the type to look past a Jim Gorman, but he's the type to be really keyed up and ready to go.
Six-man tag team action going to be hot and heavy this Monday night in SummerSlam. Of course, you got Demolition teaming up with Hacksaw, the new king of the World Wrestling Federation, against the Twin Towers and the big guy, Andre. What a six-man that's going to be as well.
Great contrasting six-man events in SummerSlam. You got the power six-man on one end, and then you have the quick six-man on the other.
Certainly hope they put a few reinforcing blocks underneath the ring. Wow, look at that nice fire that's carried.
Partners for Tito Santana, as we said before, The Rocket, Shawn Michaels, and Marty Jannetty. Let's hear from them right now.
Well, I'll tell you what, SummerSlam is right around the corner this Monday night. And I'll tell you what, with partner Tito Santana, Rick Martel and the Russo brothers are really going to feel the heat.
That's right. You talk about rocking and rolling, strutting and strolling. The Rockers got only one thing on their mind, and that's taking care of the Russos once and for all. And Rick Martel, you're going down with them.
Woo! They are ready, no question in my mind. If might want a guy that would like to place a bet on a match, Tony.
Yeah, if you were.
I would have to put my money on Tito Santana and the Rockers.
I think that would be a safe bet. Because these three men really have a score to settle. And these three men really would rather get, if you would ask them, who would they rather have in the ring, they would say, obviously, Martel and the Rougeaus.
Well, there's going to be continuity on this team, Tony. On the other team, the Rougeaus are so stuck on themselves that they're not going to let Martel get close to them. So there's going to be a little dissension in the ranks there, and that's going to show up.
But that's a great point. Garmin takes the low road now as the fans respond to Tito Santana. Great Mexican athlete who has had such a great career in the World Wrestling Federation. He'll write another chapter this Monday in a gigantic six-man during SummerSlam, and he's going to bring Garmin in the hard way.
Just a question of time in my book. Uh-oh. Tito finding a way at that point. There it is. Stick the fork in Garmin. He's done.
It's all over for Garmin. And what quickness from this man. Let's get the word on it.
I'm Sean Mooney, and we have reached the final countdown to live World Wrestling Federation action. It is now just 1 week away. It happens right here in Nashville next Saturday night, September 2nd, at the Nashville Auditorium. And let's use this chance to review this spectacular card. Now, the Hart Foundation, Bret the Hitman Hart, and Jim the Anvil Neidhart, they will face the tag team of Greg the Hammer Valentine and Dino Bravo. Also, the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase, he squares off against the Mighty Hercules. The Brainbusters, the new tag team champions, they will defend the title against the former champions Axe and Smash of Demolition. The Big Boss Man, he wants his property back. He faces Dusty Rhodes. More on that match coming up. But what about the main event? The Ultimate Warrior, he faces Andre the Giant. And right now, this bold warrior is standing by with more.
When Andre the Giant speaks, you think of numbers, large numbers. 10,000 pounds, 12 foot tall. It doesn't matter, Andre the Giant. In parts unknown, mass is nothing but variables, and fear doesn't run with the mass. You, Andre the Giant, don't live for the warriors like I do. You don't have a destiny. The warriors have spoken. Defeat Andre. Destroy Andre. 1, 2, 3!
The Ultimate Warrior to square off against Andre the Giant, also Axe and Smash of Demolition. They want the title back. They meet the new tag team champions, the Brainbusters.
You know, Demolition, you don't scare us. You don't worry us one bit. And I can prove it. Here's the proof. You know, Demolition, you're big, bad, mean, scream and holler, paint your face. But you know, you were the team that nobody could beat. But we beat you. Right on national television, because we're the smartest team in professional wrestling. Always have been. We were born to be champions, and we are the champions. The funny thing is, everybody said, Blanchard can't do it, not big enough. Anderson can't do it, not quick enough. Bobby Heenan is just missing some little something. He's not the manager, he says he is. Well, the thing is, everybody told everybody else why we couldn't do it. Bottom line is, they never told us why we couldn't do it. That's why we did it.
They are the official tag team champions, the Brainbusters, defending the title against Axe and Smash of Demolition next Saturday evening, September 2nd at the Nashville Auditorium. Right now it's time for a WWF Wipeout.
Straight X presents Great Wipeouts. They are a wild and woolly pair known as the Bushwhackers. Now, this is a tag team that could never be accused of not using their heads. Bloody lovely. Tell your mother.
Three, two, one.
Wipe on Stridex and wipe out pimples. Stridex not only wipes out pimples you have, it opens pores to help stop new ones.
Wipe out!
And Stridex removes dirt and oil. Benzoyl peroxide creams can't do that. Stridex can. Stridex. It wipes out pimples you have. It even wipes out pimples you don't have. And try Stridex Big Pads. They're made big, big, big to hold more medicine.
Crowd on hand here in Fresno as we've seen.
Absolutely. Superfly wouldn't know what to do with that belt, Tony.
Look here. Virgil now offering Ricky Itachi some money, I guess, just to forget the match and leave.
Yeah, buy him off. Itachi holding out for more.
What's he doing here? The man himself's going to offer Itachi some money. And I guess Itachi's not going to take it.
Put it right in his hand. Tells him to get out of here.
There you go. Take it.
He put it in his tights.
And now Manning. There you go. Right.
Oh, nice.
Ricky Itachi listening to us. And he took the money, and now he's going to do battle with the Million Dollar Man. And Ted DiBiase goes right after Itachi.
You know, Tony, after he let him have it with that right hand, he should have left that.
Into the corner he goes. And now, with an Irish whip to the right side, big clothesline. You know, the way we talk so much about the Superfly and his ability, this man has a world of ability also.
He certainly does. Great ring technician, the Million Dollar Man. And always that little added advantage because you've got Virgil.
That's right. Great vertical suplex. He wants Itachi to get up, but Itachi cannot at this time, so he goes right after his opponent, and he'll send him into the ropes on the left side. Meanwhile, standing by, watching this match, his opponent this Monday at SummerSlam, the Superfly.
Monday night SummerSlam, Ted DiBiase, you're going to find out what this fire in my eyes really means.
Talk about determination. You saw it on the face and in the eyes of Superfly Jimmy Snuka. What a classic matchup that's going to be, Tony.
I wouldn't want to find out what the fire in the eyes meant for the Superfly. We'll all see it, though, and you can be a part of it. SummerSlam this Monday on pay-per-view. And make sure you're a part of it this Monday night from the Meadowlands. Look at this power slam out of the ropes.
Been all downhill for Itachi since he threw that right hand. Oh, he's waiting for him now, patiently waiting to slap on a million-dollar dream. There it is.
Yes. Out will go the lights, I'm sure, very soon. Ricky Itachi, one of the most awesome holds in the WWF. And there it is. Ricky Itachi's out on his feet and now down to the mat.
Here's my...
School is out. Now we've graduated with honors. We have our diplomas. Now is the time to go out and use all the knowledge we have gained in this experience. The time has come to go out and use this knowledge to take Zeus and the Macho Man down. The time has come for offense, brother. No more defense. Offense. We have to go out and get in their faces.
Well, you know, Bruce, I've never been more comfortable with a partner in my life as I am with you, man. Over the weeks, you've proved to me time and time again that you're the best there is. But what's so funny, man, I don't mean to laugh in your face. I don't mean to laugh in all the Hulkamaniacs' faces that were concerned. But Elizabeth sat me down and laid it straight up, brother. The thing is, the prayers, the training, and the vitamins, they've never let me down. And as far as a one-on-one situation with any kind of monster, there's nobody else to believe in but myself. Because Liz told me I was the head Hulkamaniac of all time. And Brutus, once we get in there, man, once we start turning, like you said, the defense into the strongest offense ever, get the Macho Man out of my face, brother. Keep Scary Sherry at bay, because Zeus, I want to know just how powerful you are, brother. Now that we know you're nothing but a mere mortal human being, I want to find out if you can handle the largest arms in the world around your waist. I want to know if you can handle everything that I get to dish out to you. But what makes me really feel good, Brutus, is as we drank the potion down to the bottom, as we drank it down to the very last drop in the bottom of the pot, there was a pair of scissors. There was a pair of scissors right in the very bottom. And once we conquer, divide, and wipe them out, Hulkamaniacs, somebody's gonna get a haircut.
Feel the heat. See SummerSlam Monday night, August 28th. Available on a pay-per-view basis. Order now through CENTCOM Cable Television. Phone 552-2288.
This contest is scheduled for one fall.
Tony Hudson
didn't
mention where Elizabeth was going to be.
He
did not. But he and the barber are set to go. And it's going to be quite a main event. It's going to be one as much as anything else.
Mistake.
I think he did also, Gorilla. Rugged Ronnie Garvin and Boris Zukov set to go. Zukov from behind on Rugged Ronnie Garvin. He is going right after Garvin, not wasting any time at all. And this may or may not be the right thing to do, but it's really his strategy right now. And I tell you what, those blows are really finding their mark.
They certainly are.
You think all this time off may have hurt Ronnie Garvin?
Well, he's been training constantly. I doubt it very much, Tony.
There was my answer right there. He is really slugging out. The big Russian goes down. And Garvin grabs the man by the beard. Big headbutt. Garvin is ready. We have some pre-recorded comments from Rugged Ronnie Garvin.
You know, Greg Valentine, when you thought you had it all figured out, that everything was going to go your way, you was going to go to better things, you got rid of Ronnie Garvin. Well, now it backfired on you. You're going to be on to some better way. I'm going to tell you what it's going to be. It's going to be a better beating, the best you've ever had in your life.
Garvin over the top.
Boy, he can dish out beatings. Look at this. Nice backdrop. History.
And you can better believe that Greg Valentine has to think about Hercules and SummerSlam this Monday.
Here is your winner, Rugged Ronnie Garvin.
What a tremendous arrangement for this young man with a triumphant return here. Look at the agility. Right up over the top, and watch this backdrop. Wow, big rush and knocked the wind out of himself, and then that big right hand will put anybody away.
Let's get our special interview.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, my guests, along with their manager, Sensational Sherry, are the human wrecking machine, Zeus, and Macho Man, Randy Savage.
Here they come, and there's some Hulkamaniacs. Listen to the response.
Time for the talking is just about over, Tony Schiavone.
Tremendous speculation in the air as to where Miss Elizabeth will be this Monday night for SummerSlam.
There should be no speculation to where Miss Elizabeth is going to be this Monday night at SummerSlam. Sensational Sherry, right now, tell the entire world exactly where Miss Elizabeth is going to be. Oh, yeah!
do when you're in the ring with Hulk Hogan one on one.
Hulk Hogan! The way you fit your t-shirt! Oh! It's the way I am going to tear your head! Oh!
Well, I think it's obvious.
Well, you don't have both arms in the water, Tony.
Not at all. He does not want to defeat Hulk Hogan. He wants to take the man out. SummerSlam is this Monday.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are counting down to SummerSlam this coming Monday night with an 8 p.m. Eastern start. You can be part of it. The hottest wrestling spectacular of this or any other summer. Call your local cable system right now. It's so easy to join us for SummerSlam on a pay-per-view basis. You talk about your action. We've heard from Hulk Hogan and Brutus the Barber Beefcake earlier on. The Macho Man Randy Savage and Zeus, what a head-on collision between these four men. In the corner of the Macho Man and Zeus, Sensational Sherry. I'm curious, where will Elizabeth be this Monday night for SummerSlam? All right, proceeding on with the action. Honky Tonk Man, is this guy something else? He is, and so is his opponent, Americana Dusty Rhodes.
Woo, this Monday it is here, the heat is on. SummerSlam. Honky Tonk Man, Honky Wood, and the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. Singing's over, dancing's over. Now it's time to pay them dues, Honky. Because I got these big old sticks, I got these handcuffs, and you got the guitar with my name all over. Monday we're going to find out who really is the hit maker. Woo, yeah!
I'm going to make the assumption this Monday night in SummerSlam there could be a whole lot of shaking going on when Americana Dusty Rhodes beats the Honky Tonk Man. Jimmy Superfly Snuka squares off against the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase. How about this one? The Hart Foundation, Bret the Hitman Hart, Jim the Anvil Neidhart, to meet Tully Blanchard and Arn Anderson, Brainbusters, the new World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions. Here's a six-man tag that could turn into a Pier 6 brawl. Let's hear from all parties. Demolition and their partner, King Hacksaw Jim Duggan, and these three men, the Twin Towers and Andre the Giant.
Demolition! We got you already. We take the belt away from you. And now you got that goofy guy, Jigsaw, don't you?
What a goof.
Wizard fool! Nothing but a wizard fool! Tell him about it, Slick.
In SummerSlam, you are looking at the winners right here, brother. One, two, three, right in the middle.
Well, but SummerSlam, we're going to be the big smash.
SummerSlam, we're going to take the Twin Towers and the Eiffel Tower.
Twin Towers, you already know what we're all about. Andre the Giant, you're going to find out.
And after the SummerSlam matches, it's not just going to be a party. It's going to be a celebration.
The one thing I find unique about this big six-man tag, you will have nearly three-quarters of a ton, nearly 1,500 pounds of beef on the hoof. And that six-man tag with the Towers and Andre going against Demolition and King, Hacksaw Jim Duggan. A couple of other matches, another six-man tag, the Rockers and Tito Santana to meet the Fabulous Rougeos and Rick Martel. Hercules squares off against Greg the Hammer Valentine. Red Rooster will be going against Mr. Perfect Kurt Hennig. And Ravishing Rick Rude, the current reigning Intercontinental Champion, meets this man, Challenger, the Ultimate Warrior.
What will take place this Monday night at SummerSlam, Ravishing Rickford, has already been written on the wall, and the pages have already been filed in the history books. One last question has been answered in the destiny of the Ultimate Warrior. As you become a skeleton in our closet, the power of the Ultimate Warrior only continues to grow!
All right, that's it in a nutshell, ladies and gentlemen. The hottest wrestling spectacular of the summer coming up this Monday night with an 8 p.m. start Eastern Time, SummerSlam. Get on the horn right now before you do anything else this weekend. Get on a phone, contact your local cable system, and be part of SummerSlam as it happens this Monday night. Again, I repeat, the match the world has been waiting for. Brutus the Barber Beefcake and Hulk Hogan team up to meet the Macho Man, Randy Savage, and the human wrecking machine, Zeus. SummerSlam this Monday night. Don't you dare miss it. With the SummerSlam Report, I'm Gene Okerlund.
SummerSlam, there's going to be not only a tag team contest, there's going to be a couple of six-man contests.
And his partner,
these two men, Mark Ming and Bob Allen, going up against, and you hear the music, the Baddies Rougeaux. And speaking of the Baddies Rougeaux, they're involved in that big six-man because there's the Slickster and Rick Martel.
Got the whole group there, Tony. Disgusting individuals, Jacques and Ramon.
The Rougeaux.
Two hypocrites.
And I guess you're referring to their allegiance to the...
Yeah, their allegiance to the American dollar.
Allegiance to the American dollar.
Not the American flag, you're right, the dollar.
Now, we take a look at Jacques Rougeaux starting up against Bob Allen, and I guess we're going to have a little show-off time here, as we always do.
To do.
You know, you brought up a good point earlier when you talked about the Rougeaux and Rick Martel being busy showing off during their match against the Rockers and Tito Santana. A lot of showboating, I'm sure. And you got three men with three very big egos, obviously. And that may prove to be their downfall.
Gigantic egos, Tony. To me, there's not going to be all that much continuity on this team come this Monday night. And you can bet your last bottom dollar that neither the Rockers nor Tito Santana will fall for any of this kind of garbage.
Well, if Jacques Rougeaux does a nip up like that, Santana and the Rockers...
Why would you even attempt to do something like that? By this time in the match Monday night, Tony, Jacques would have been hit with 17 drop kicks and 22 flying head scissors.
That's right, Gorilla. That's exactly what will happen. And why wouldn't the Rougeaux want to wrestle? Why wouldn't they want to go after their opponents to get in shape, maybe even more so, or get in preparation for the big six-man? I guess that question will be answered Monday night in that big six-man during SummerSlam. Look at Jacques.
Oh, nice drop kick off the second turnbuckle on the inside.
So much ability from the Rougeaux as Jacques goes after his opponent once again. Two men will make a difference, maybe, though, and they're standing by right now.
Final Slicks for SummerSlam this Monday night. Tricky Ricky Martel and my fabulous Rougeaux brothers. We're going to be ready, baby.
Exactly. What we have is one taco breath and no good contemporary hippies. But I promise you, in SummerSlam, hands are going to roll.
Boy, there's two guys you got to keep your eye on all the time, no question.
And two men that the Rockers and Tito Santana especially are going to have to keep their eye on during SummerSlam this Monday.
Well, Raymond looks good. Jacques looks a little bit out of shape to me, Tony, if that's possible. Got a little curvy hanging out. Nice flying elbow, though.
He, though, is taking the measure. He slaps Allen in the face, going right after Ming again.
From the background.
And
Exhibition action has now come down to being just 1 week away. It happens next Saturday evening, September 2nd, at the Nashville Auditorium. Included in this great night is Hercules meeting the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase. He's standing by with comments.
Virgil, look who's knocking on the door. Look who's knocking on the door, the Million Dollar Man, one more time. The mighty Hercules. Yes, Hercules, you're a big, impressive man. I said that a long time ago when I offered you the opportunity of a lifetime to join the team, to stand here alongside with me with Virgil. But you didn't take the offer, and now you're suffering for it. And you will suffer one more time when that bell rings. You'll wear that chain around your throat.
Mighty Hercules taking on the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase. As you could tell from those comments, the Million Dollar Man very confident about this match. The Big Boss Man, he'll tangle with Dusty Rhodes.
Who is getting warm for the Boss Man? And that slick be prancing around, dancing and everything until I came on the scene. What came on the scene? American Justice came on the scene. And the Boss Man lost his pretty toys. These hurt, Boss Man. They hurt bad. You've been whipping people with them. You've been cuffing them up. But now, then, the shoe to say is on the other feet. Because now you and Slick got to deal with Americana. Boss Man, my justice is gonna be hot.
Well, Dusty Rhodes, nightstick and cuffs in hand when he meets the Big Boss Man next Saturday evening, September 2nd. Also at the Nashville Auditorium, Bad News Brown. He'll be here in singles competition. And tag team action, don't miss the Hart Foundation, meeting Greg the Hammer Valentine and Dino Bravo. The Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase, we heard from him earlier. He faces the Mighty Hercules. Also, the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Championship on the line. Champions, the Brain Busters, facing the former title holders, Action Smash of Demolition. The Big Boss Man take on Dusty Rhodes. You just heard his comments. And the Ultimate Warrior facing Andre the Giant. What a battle this match has turned into. It all takes place next Saturday evening, September 2nd, at the Nashville Auditorium.